Globalization and the Indian Economy. Objective: in this topic, we will learn about Indian economy. As consumers in today's world, some of us have a wide choice of goods and services before us. The latest models of digital cameras, mobile phones, and televisions made by the leading manufacturers of the world are within our reach. Indians are buying cars produced by nearly all the top companies in the world. In a matter of years, our markets have been transformed. How do we understand these rapid transformations? What are the factors that are bringing about these changes affecting the lives of people? A multinational company is a company that owns or controls production in more than one nation. Multinational companies set up offices and factories for production in regions where they can get cheap labor and other resources. This is done so that the cost of production is low and the multinational companies can earn greater profits. The multinational company not only sells its finished product globally, but more importantly, the goods and services are produced globally. As a result, production is organized in increasingly complex ways. In general, multinational companies set up production where it is close to the markets, where there is skilled and unskilled labor available at low costs, and where the availability of other factors of production is assured. Having assured themselves of these conditions, multinational companies set up factories and offices for production. The money that is spent to buy assets such as land, building, machines, and other equipment is called investment. Investments made by multinational companies are called foreign investments. Any investment is made with the hope that these assets will earn profits. For a long time, foreign trade has been the main channel connecting countries. In history, you would have read about the trade routes connecting India and South Asia to markets both in the East and the West. Extensive trade took place along these routes. Foreign trade creates an opportunity for the producers to reach beyond the domestic markets, that is, markets of their own countries. Producers can sell their produce not only in markets located within the country, but can also compete in markets located in other countries of the world. Similarly, for the buyers, import of goods produced in another country is one way of expanding the choice of goods beyond what is domestically produced. That is all in this topic. In the next topic, we will learn about globalization.